Hello everyone, today let's discuss about statics and dynamics. Before getting into the topic, please, subscribe to the channel for more mechanical engineering videos. Statics and dynamics are two fundamental branches of mechanics that deal with the behavior of objects in different states of motion. Statics is the branch of mechanics that deals with objects that are at rest, or in a state of equilibrium. In statics, the focus is on studying the forces and moments acting on objects without considering their motion, such as buildings, bridges, towers, etc. A static force refers to a constant force applied to a stationary object. A static force is too weak to move an object, because it is being countered by equally strong opposite forces. The most common example of a static force is weight of a body. It is nothing but the amount of gravitational force acting on it. The gravitational constant is the same for all the objects present on the surface of the Earth. Pushing a heavy block. While pushing a heavy block that does not move upon applying a significant amount of force, the presence of a force of friction can be felt. It has a magnitude greater than the applied force. Followed by an object placed on a high surface. It possesses a significant amount of potential energy. The state of the body does not change, and the state of equilibrium is maintained. Therefore, the forces acting on such an object only contributes to preserve the state of the rest of the object. A hook and loop arrangement. A hook suspended in a loop does not fall or gets displaced from its position. This is because a force acting in between two objects forbids any type of change in the position or the location. The force acting on the arrangement, therefore, is balanced and static in nature. Next is statics moment. A moment, often referred to as torque, is a rotational force around an axis. It is the product of a force and the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation to the line of action of the force. Examples: a door opening around a fixed hinge, seesaws, scissors, or a spanner turning around a nut. Static equilibrium. It takes place when all the forces acting on an object are balanced, and the object is not in motion in relation to the relative plane. An object is in static equilibrium when the vector sum of all forces acting on it is zero. Applications. Statics plays a crucial role in various areas of mechanical engineering, including structural analysis, determining the stability and safety of buildings, bridges, and other structures. Machine design, ensuring that machine components are balanced and don't cause unintended movements. Aerospace engineering, analyzing the forces acting on aircraft and spacecraft during different phases of flight. Civil engineering, assessing the stability of retaining walls, dams, and other civil structures. Followed by that, we are going to discuss about dynamics. Dynamics refers to the study of how objects and systems behave when subjected to forces and moments that cause them to move and change their state of motion. Dynamics is divided into kinematics and kinetics. Kinematics describes the motion of objects, while kinetics studies forces that cause changes of motion. Dynamics considers the forces and moments acting on objects and how they influence the object's motion. Engineers use principles like Newton's laws of motion to analyze how forces affect the acceleration and behavior of objects. Dynamics is concerned with understanding how objects move, whether they are accelerating, decelerating, or moving at a constant velocity. It involves tracking the position, velocity, and acceleration of objects over time. Applications. Dynamics is applied to a wide range of mechanical engineering applications, including vehicle dynamics, analyzing how cars, aircraft, and other vehicles respond to steering, braking, and acceleration forces to ensure safe and stable motion. Machine design, ensuring that machines and mechanical systems are designed to operate efficiently and reliably by considering dynamic forces and stresses. Robotics, understanding the motion and control of robotic systems, which often involves complex dynamic analyses. Vibration analysis, studying how mechanical systems vibrate, which is crucial for designing structures and machinery to minimize vibrations and avoid resonance. Mechanical systems, analyzing the behavior of gears, linkages, and other mechanical components to ensure smooth and efficient operation. Newton's laws of motion can divide it into three types: Newton's first, second, and third law of motion. Newton's first law states that if a body is at rest, or moving at a constant speed in a straight line, it will remain at rest, or keep moving in a straight line at constant speed unless it is acted upon by a force. Newton's second law of motion states that F equals ma, or net force, is equal to mass times acceleration. A larger net force acting on an object causes a larger acceleration, and objects with larger mass require more force to accelerate. Newton's third law states that for every action or force in nature, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Energy is a term that describes the ability to do work or cause change. In the context of mechanics, it's the driving force behind the movement and operation of machines and objects. Energy comes in various forms, like nuclear energy, electrical energy, chemical energy, mechanical energy, gravitational energy, magnetic energy, etc. Mechanical energy is the energy associated with the motion and position of objects. It can be divided into two types, kinetic energy and potential energy. Kinetic energy of translation is the kinetic energy due to rectilinear motion, and the kinetic energy of rotation is the kinetic energy due to rotary motion. Potential energy is all about an object's position or state. Objects can have potential energy due to their height, compression or stretching, or chemical composition. The law of conservation of energy, a fundamental principle in physics, dictates that the total energy within a closed system remains constant, with no creation or destruction of energy, but rather transformations between different forms. Thank you for watching.